What it is, guys, it's your Dino. We're back again with another review, so let's just get straight into this one. This is for Bakery Simulator. Bakery Simulator is basically a simulator for baking. It allows you to make every single recipe in this game is based or inspired by real ones. This game is available only on Steam, as far as I'm aware, as of recording this. It is an indie casual simulation game published by Gaming Factory and Ultimate Games, and the developer is Live Motion Games. And as of recording this, it has received a 7 out of 10 on Steam's rating system. So this game's minimum requirements is a 64-bit processor and operating system that runs either Windows 7, 8, or 10. The processor can be Intel i3 core 4130 or an AMD Thenom 2X4 with about 6 gigs of RAM, and either a GTX 560 or an AMD R7 260X, and runs on the DirectX version 11. So basically, the target of this game is that your store needs a different kind of baked goods, breads, buns, and they are just not enough. Some expect croissants, some expect bagels, some expect muffins, and you need to browse a daily list of orders and choose them and commit to regular deliveries. Raise your reputation and trust with the stores by making the deliveries on time, driving to different points, or using a delivery service to get your deliveries ordered. Make sure you pay and tip the drivers, otherwise you might end up with your goods being damaged. You don't want that, and then you have to earn and invest in your own bakery by upgrading your equipment and getting upgrades for each individual thing and buying new items and upgrading those, and so on and so forth. This game is of the same ilk of Pressure Washer Simulator, the Train Simulator one, where you have to build a train station or train stop yard or whatever it's called, Lawn Mowing Simulator, House Flipper. They run off the same style, where you can move around in first person and do the tasks that are needed manually yourself. It is pretty cool for what it is. If you like this style of game, it is definitely going to give you plenty of hours worth of gameplay. You can customize your bakery space, and you can like paint it, you can put tiles up, you could do all sorts of things that you could do in the gas stop simulator and stuff like that, and make them look really nice and pretty. It has an open world where you need to be aware of the market that you have, and like make sure you're selling the right goods. You need to earn and invest and buy new equipment. The baking is actually quite fun to do. It does actually use real world weights and measurements, and the techniques that they use are quite realistic. And the resource management, you buy your ingredients, work under a time pressure, and choose what you want to accomplish. It's actually quite a good game. It's, whilst it's a simulation game, it also requires basic time management skills and stuff like that, and I feel like that's a really cool game. So it's really chill. I think that they've done a really good job of it. I feel that for those kinds of content creators who like the simulator games, this is just right up your alley. You'll have a lot of fun with it. I know that it could be good for streams, because it could be a very chill stream. It's definitely something that I feel that could do very well in the content creator space. It is, however, not something that I would probably create much more content around, because it requires a lot of focus for me, and I'd end up ignoring chat or struggling to stay talkative when I'm playing the game, because it requires me to focus heavily. That's just my personal preference. That's just me. I will say that on a level of accessibility, it doesn't have any mappability for it. You can't change certain buttons, you can't use a controller, and that is for me a big letdown, because I really do prefer games that have the ability to remap controls and stuff like that, because it makes it easier for me to play. But that's a me issue and not a you issue, because everyone is different. We all play different styles of games, and we play at different levels of accessibility. Some of us need to use accessibility controllers and stuff like that. So having a game be mindful of that is always a good thing. That's just my opinion though. If you do like this style of game, please sound off in the comments. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Or if you want to recommend this game to a friend, please go ahead and do so, because I'd love it for you guys to share out the content to people you think might enjoy this style of game and would appreciate the review. I will post a link to the game on Steam down in the description, and I'll try and pin one in the comments if you guys remind me if I forget to do so. But as always, that is my opinion and where I feel that it could be taken. You guys can always have a difference of opinion, and I'd love to discuss it with you. I feel that this game does offer a very diverse portfolio of recipes and baking tools and methods and stuff like that. They've done a very good job of making this baking simulator as real to life as possible within the confines of a computer game. They have got quite a few different areas where they could probably make improvements. There is a big issue with the way that the delivery system works, where you have to deliver the cars. It does feel a little bit janky in that area, like the game has issues with that. But it's clear that that hasn't been the focus of the game. That is a secondary thing that they have not wanted to divert a lot of resources and time into. They've focused on the simulator aspect of the game. I feel that they've done a very good job overall, and I would definitely say this game is worth its 7 out of 10 that Steam have given it. I personally will always say that it's always down to the fun factor. If a game is fun, it doesn't matter whether it's got good graphics or bad graphics, as long as you are having fun with it, and that is the key thing for most people. I will say that I know a couple of content creators that I will be recommending this game to, because they do play a lot of simulator style games, and I feel that they would enjoy it. This could do well on any platform out there where you can stream or create content, YouTube, TikTok. It could do well everywhere if you can create the unique content that you want to create with it. And as a gamer, I feel like this game is tailored to all styles of gamer, be them the hardcore gamer or the more casual player who just gets to sit down for a little bit and just have a go. This is definitely one that I feel that could do very well. But that's my opinion. That's where I see the game going. And I feel like it could progress further if the developers still support it long term and come up with extra content and updates for the game. I'd love to hear what you guys think. If you like the look of the game, if you like the review, don't forget to hit the like button, sound off in the comments, share it out on social media, or share it to a friend who likes that kind of content or that kind of game. And as always, remember guys, we do also stream on the channel. All the links to everything will be down in the description. We stream on the channel from Tuesday through to Sunday. We do community games, we do story games, and it's always great to see you guys pop by. And thank you for all the love and support to all the members that have been supporting the channel of late. You guys have been killing it. Thank you very much. Thank you for all the love and support. It does really mean the world to me. Thank you so much. But as always, guys, that's my opinion on the game. I definitely think that it has a lot of fun factor. It has a lot to offer, and I feel that it could do very well in multiple spaces and for multiple styles of gamers. I feel that the biggest letdown for the game is its level of accessibility for people who are less able-bodied, but that's probably down to the way the game is designed, because it really does require mouse and keyboard and is kind of constrained by that. But that's my opinion. If you like the opinion, guys, let me know. If you don't like it, sound off in the comments and let me know, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.